So we have a show now. This is the sumptuous office of Peter Travers, film critic of Rolling Stone, and you, Diablo Cody, are seated here for the first time in your life. Please do not shake. Do not
I'm sorry, did you see me trembling?
I saw
I'm hypoglycemic, I swear, I'm not nervous.
It was really hard. And we just happened to have a poster of Jennifer's Body, the film that you have written, here.
It just coincidentally happens to be affixed to the wall.
Yeah.
I like that, I'm glad you're a fan.
You know, usually we just have like direct Scorsese or Clint Eastwood, but...
Who?
Today, nobody cares.
Who are these people?
Nobody cares. But to start, I've been starting this whole thing that I've been doing on my podcast, which is called Damn You Hollywood. And I just think it's like a great way to start an interview with you rather than me saying it. So if I said, damn you Hollywood, what would you damn Hollywood for?
I would damn Hollywood for creating a clone army of overcoached young actors who do not express their own beliefs anymore.
Wow. And we all know who they are.
Yeah.
But we're not going to say.
The publicists have ruined...
Why? Because they threaten your lives. This is a movie, a horror movie, but more than that, really completely controlled by women. I know it's released through it, but there's you. You wrote it.
I wrote it.
Karin Kusama directed it. Megan Fox and Amanda Seyfried are in it. How's that happen? Usually some guys get involved somewhere.
I said to myself at the beginning, I said, even if this movie is a colossal failure, at the very least we pulled off this sort of strange and unusual feat of creating like a completely female-controlled horror film. But the fact of the matter is we wanted to make something unusual and subversive and take a risk. And obviously, Hollywood is not in the business of risk-taking.
No, they don't
like
it.
Not typically.
Not typically, you know. We don't see it very often. So when you were deciding who should play it, why suddenly did you think of Megan as this person?
I started talking to her and I realized, like, I was very intimidated. We sat down at a bar because in those days Megan Fox could walk into a bar and not be completely mobbed by fanboys. And normally I feel like this camaraderie with young actresses, and you know, it's something about Juno just created this kind of goodwill, and especially when I talk to girls. But with Megan, I felt very intimidated. Like, she was, like, sort of powerful and, like, regal.
Just have it.
For real. Mm-hmm. And she locked in.
Who did you have to convince after that?
Nobody.
Nobody.
There was overwhelming enthusiasm.
Good.
For that,
see?
For the idea, yeah.
So there's sort of happy Hollywood stories to do.
Yeah, it was a happy story. Yeah. I mean, they really took a chance on this one, like, Maverick Hall.
Diablo Cody. I say that name because that's not your real name.
That's not my name.
Brooke, but... Which do you call yourself?
Brooke, absolutely.
Always Brooke. You don't go around. Friends don't call you Diablo.
People that have like met me in the last couple of years will occasionally call me Diablo, as if it's it's just a nickname among friends. But I prefer to be called Brooke, and like Diablo is silly.
No, it's not silly.
I think it definitely suits the. It suits me for purposes of promoting this film, but will
it
ever
really does.
I don't know if it'll ever suit me in any other capacity.
It's as if you were always heading for that.
That
was the reason for it. I want to ask you, because you're in this position, and I totally feel for you in it as a writer, somebody that is actually a voice. When you do Juno, it's you. Nobody really sounded like that before. When we see Jennifer's Body, it's you. And then you won, after a career in stripping and writing about it, an Oscar. So you might as well have a giant target written. Do you feel any of that?
I can't fault
negativity?
People. That's the thing.
We can always fault people. We love to do it.
It's difficult for me, but I could see how I could be obnoxious to people. I don't think I'm obnoxious as a human being, but my career trajectory is so improbable that I would think this Diablo Cody is an overrated piece of shit. For sure. Like, I would probably be leading the backlash. Personal attacks and weird things like that, I don't understand. Like, these people, they haven't actually had a beer with me, so they don't know.
These are from a couple of your tweets. I think I just saw Beyonce's fallopian tubes.
Did you see Beyonce last night?
I did, yeah.
Wow.
Wow, and I think I saw them too.
Yeah.
So it's there. I like this. Just saw Megan Fox and Adam Brody on MTV pretending they're not madly in love with me. The charade must end soon, my darlings.
Well, did you see them saunter on? They were all casual, like just kind of introducing Green Day. Uh-huh. And they were acting as if they were like normal people and not like in the throes of unrequited obsession with me,
mm-hmm.
which they are. Like,
they are.
Both they want me so bad.
To just be with them and to hang out with them.
They
want to
be with me. They like, it's ruining their lives.
Mm-hmm. And my favorite is, I don't like being away from my dogs. I need a cold, wet snout to graze my crotch as I'm getting dressed.
These are all really recent tweets.
Well, fine.
I have a huge body of work. And you fixated on the last 2 days.
I had to fixate on what I said. Because that's just the way we are here in this office.
I don't know why.
Twitter therapy.
I don't know why I'm a creative exhibitionist in this way. But I was raised Catholic, and I think like there was such an emphasis on confessing that the idea.
Me too. It's the same thing.
The idea of being able to talk about how I feel every day to a captive audience, mm-hmm. is so delicious.
But who may or may not forgive you. The thing about confession is
that
you could just go and sin no more.
I'm pretty sure I have not been absolved by anybody in the Twitterverse, I'm going to keep going.
When I was talking about the hurt, I really mean it, because it's personal. Everything is personal, as if you let that personal stuff in. And with you, with the writing and someone saying, don't be too much of that.
Oh, abso-freaking-lutely. More for women than men. For sure. Mm-hmm. If I take a picture of kissing my Oscar, which, you know, I did on the spur of the moment because like a foreign journalist yelled, kiss your Oscar.
Kiss your Oscar, yeah.
Then it's like, oh, look at her like miming fellatio or like being an attention whore. Every year a different actor kisses his Oscar, and mm-hmm. I see the picture every year and nobody ever says anything like that. They say, what a sweet picture of so-and-so in his wonderful moment.
You don't have a normal career trajectory.
No, I have the weirdest career in the world, and there's no one I can talk to. I've gone to like other writers and directors and been like, let's talk about, and it's occurred to me slowly, like you're not going to find someone with whom to commiserate, mm-hmm. because you are the only person to whom this has ever happened.
In the beginning, it was all, well, she started as a stripper. And then you wrote that book after you did the blog and the
I wrote the
ranch,
book before my screenwriting career,
right.
though. And the thing is, because the book exists, which I still find the book hilarious, when people would ask me about stripping, mm-hmm. and to this day, I feel like it would be disingenuous to say, I don't want to talk about that. Mm-hmm. I wrote a fucking book about it.
You did, yeah, so
like,
you got to talk about it.
Right, but
people were passing, they knew you were coming, and they kept saying, what was her favorite song to strip to?
Which is, I wrote a whole list of them in the book.
I know, but I don't even want to hear one.
I always liked, because I think the songs you connect to are the ones that were sexy when you came of age, so I always wanted to strip to Def Leppard and stuff, which doesn't work, by the way.
It doesn't, but it's
like guys don't want to see a girl strip to Def Leppard. Can I ask you a question?
I'm Tammy,
you wanted me to bring my Oscar here.
I did. That's why I had that.
Which I could not do
because you don't live here, so you would.
I would
have
had to bring it through Toronto and here, and it just seemed like internationally it was.
Why did I want you?
Yeah, that's what I wanted to know.
Because I think from people I know who have them that it's a better fetish than almost anything else in the world. People want to. You can't tell me that your friends.
Oh no!
Don't come to your. Where is it? Where does the damn thing sit?
It's sitting right in my living room, and I'm not precious about it. Like people come over and carry it around.
They would have sex with it. If they were left alone in the room. I remember once saying to Martin Scorsese, people are going to come in, they're going to touch it, and they're going to go away with it. And he said, they can't touch it, they can't do anything with it. And I'm saying, no, they will, because I've seen people in elevators silently touching it alone, you know? And
sometimes people say to me, you know what, they'll come up very close to it, like people in the industry, and they'll be like, I'm not going to touch it because it's bad luck. You can't touch it until you got your own. And I'm always like, don't hold your breath.
That's right. I'll do it. Here it comes. Yeah. Well, even without the Oscar, it was great to have you here. And you get a prize.
What is it?
I give these DVDs. You can only take one.
Oh, I was checking them out.
You would be absolutely amazed by this one.
Oh my God. I'm going to watch this tonight.
And for special guests, we also
Let's make a sandwich is a wonderful...
Everybody gets a Rolling Stone Obama shirt.
Oh, you're kidding me.
Yeah. So
oh,
this
that's
isn't,
awesome.
I mean, it seems like a cheap
show. I voted for McCain, but...
Well, it's okay. I think it'd be better for you to wear it when you have the Draco hair. Because I don't know how long you're going to keep.
I love the Draco comparison is really great. I like that.
Travers, go and see it. If you don't go see it, he'll come see you and stick you in a pile of poo.